Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Himani Khanna. I'm a developmental behavioral pediatrician, a co-founder and a director at Continua Kids. So my today's video focuses on how to plan intervention for our children with special needs. So any child with developmental delays or any child with special needs, whoever is planning an intervention, be it a special educator, a psychologist, or a parent also if he's involved, or a doctor, whoever is planning the intervention must keep these four rules in mind whenever they are planning an intervention for a child with special needs. So the first principle would be, let the intervention plan be individualized according to the need of the child. So adjust all the intervention that you are planning according to the IQ level of the child, according to the functional level of the child, and also keep in mind the problem behavior of that particular child so that you can address them. So first is, let the plan be individualized. The second principle is, it has to be comprehensive. Whatever intervention plan you are making has to cover all developmental domains, from motor milestones to adaptive language skills or social skills and cognitive domains. So it has to cover all domains of the development. And the intervention also must happen in multiple contexts. The intervention shouldn't just happen in an intervention center. The intervention should happen in the community also, at home also, in school also. So it has to happen in multiple contexts, and the intervention has to be comprehensive. The third principle will be, the skills that you plan to teach the child should be according to the developmental level of the child. So a child develops in a certain way normally also. They acquire simple skills before they go on to acquire complex skills. So when planning intervention, you can't hop on to directly planning the complex skills. If a child is 3 years old, you can't straight away plan a complex skill according to the age of the child. Plan according to the developmental level of the child. Teach a simple skill before you go on to plan a complex skill. The fourth and important principle, most important principle I would say, that you need to keep in mind is, the intervention has to be early and intensive. Early intervention is as soon as you identify a developmental delay or a deviance from development while the child is being seen by the doctor. Investigations are planned and the diagnosis is being made. The intervention should start happening. So early stimulation, early intervention, and intensive intervention. So in early phase only, if we do early and intensive intervention, it is very well known in research and in science. We have so many evidences which say that the long-term outcome, neurodevelopmental outcome of the children is much better if we do an early and intensive intervention. So just need to keep these four rules in mind, and then plan intervention for any child with developmental delays or child with special needs or any child with any deviation in their development from a typical developmental pathway. I hope my today's video is useful for you all. Thank you for watching.